All right, we're recording. So do Laura and Lauren or Grant, do you want me to critique your page first?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I care who you do first.
So either one of you?
Yeah.
All three of you want me to do it though?
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Sometimes people get a little bit nervous thinking that I'm going to like rip them apart or something, but I promise I won't do that. All right, I'll share my screen with you guys so we're all on the same page. Okay, so I'll just go to Lauren Phillips first because you're the first person I see. So Lauren, for everyone that doesn't know, just joined, was it 2 days ago or 3 days ago?
Like Monday, so yeah.
Monday.
Three days.
Okay, so you probably know from the training, but I ask people usually to post 3 to 5 times a day. And since you just started, I don't know if you're doing that, which would be completely fine. And like most people won't have too many, or most people will have a lot of posts. But one thing that I keep in mind when doing the critiquing is I try and just scroll down once or twice. And those are the only posts I look at, because when people go to your page, they're not going to keep scrolling and scrolling to find the amazing post that you had a month ago. You know, they're going to look just like at your most recent post. So for you, it's most likely just this week, which is perfect.
Right. Yep.
Okay. So the first thing is usually like the cover photo and your photo. For the cover photo, I would try to make it, like, you can include this photo because I really like it and it looks like you're a family person and you value your family, but try and make a cover photo that has different things that you value and that also includes health and fitness. So the reason for that is because when people come to your page, especially new friends, like when you start adding people to your network, that's the first thing that they will see. Mm-hmm. And so you want them to be like, oh, she likes her family, she likes her boyfriend, she likes her pets, she likes fitness, you know, it's just so like a broader view of you.
Okay.
Okay.
Lauren, did I tell you about PicMonkey?
No.
So PicMonkey is a website that you can go to. And that's how I made my cover photo. So it's like an app for your phone, but just on your computer. Oh yeah, there's, yeah, okay.
Oh. Yeah, so just click design. Cover photo.
Cool. All right.
And then, Sam, can you show her how to add your own photo? That was confusing me.
Yeah. So you can do design and then Facebook cover. And then you click on the butterfly over here.
Okay.
And it has, like, you can add squares or hearts or stars. I do a lot of, but you can add your own by clicking on your own.
Oh, okay.
And then just opening it up.
Oh, all right.
So, and then you can like play around with it, get creative. You can place them anywhere you want. Another idea that you could do is from the front page. Instead of doing design and Facebook cover, you can do edit.
Okay.
Computer. Oh, wait, not edit. What is it? Oh, collage. Sorry, collage. Computer, and then just pick like random photos that you'd want to include.
Okay.
Click open. And then you click on the second option here, like the layouts. Mm-hmm. And there's Facebook cover.
Oh, okay.
So here, and it gives you different options for like the how big you want each photo.
Right.
And you just drag and drop. So this is really easy if you don't want to be too creative on your own.
Okay.
This is how I started. I did it like this. And then you can go to this last paint option and like remove the spaces or add some corners, change the background color. So you can do, and then you can do edit. Open an editor. This is a crash course. and edit will just bring you right back to where we were with the, where you can add more photos or add text and things like that.
All right. Oh, sweet. Thanks.
Yeah, no problem. So, let's see. I won't try and read every single one, but let's see. Yeah, so this is like a good motivational post. That's a good one. Win of the day. Oh, nice. So she's here, she's like talking about kind of like results, you know, from what you're doing. More motivation. Good photo. Videos. I love videos. Videos get a lot of engagement, not only because it's a video, but like logically on Facebook, videos get shown more than photos. So okay. Do a video when possible. And I commented on that.
Nice.
Nice. Yeah, honestly, I think this is really good, especially for just starting. On Monday, you have like hobbies, your program.
That's me.
So the only thing that I think...
I love that photo.
I know, this is a great one. So the only thing I see here, you have like motivation, you have your personal stuff, you have your workouts, and some meals. You might just want to add a little bit more variety, like maybe a healthy meal that you had. Okay. These stock photos are really good. I mean, and this is like one of the only ones I saw you post, but what's even better than posting these is posting that same quote on one of your photos. So maybe like have a picture of, it's talking about building a life that you don't need to escape from. So maybe it's like you at your computer doing some beach body work with that quote on the bottom.
Okay.
You know, so make it more personal so people see you, but also have that motivation in there.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, so you're doing really well. I don't know if I have much else other than that to say.
Thanks.
Yeah. Do you have any questions or anything?
No, I mean, I guess I just take one post at a time.
Mm-hmm.
I try to think of like, I'm trying to do 3 a day.
Okay.
But for now, but like if I try to think of a lie at once, I get overwhelmed and then I don't know what to do. So I just take one. Whatever I'm feeling at the moment, I guess.
Yeah. So do you have specific times that you're posting those three or just like whenever you feel like it?
I always do one in the morning, probably around like 7:30 or 8 in the morning, and one around 1 in the afternoon, and then one like 6-ish at night.
That's a good time because I noticed this was 7 hours ago, so I would probably post one tonight.
Okay. Yep.
Lauren, you did post one though. You
posted the food one. I don't know why it's out of order. There's a... That one,
yeah. Oh, that's weird. I wonder why that happened.
Yeah.
Okay, well, then that's good. Yeah, those are good times.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for my Shakeology to come so I can have more. I don't have it yet. So.
Yeah. That'll be better. It's good, though, because you're showing your program, so.
Yeah. Thanks.
Okay, cool. All right, we'll go to Lauren, the other Lauren. Okay, cool. So your cover photo is awesome. I like that you have Instagram and your email here because right up front, if someone's interested, they see like, okay, I love your shirt. You're doing T25. You have a daughter that's super cute. Then like right away, they want to contact you. This tells them right away where they can find you or at least follow your other stuff. So that's a good thing to have. Okay, let's see. So from 6 hours ago, so again, Lauren, you might want to post tonight, especially because most people are online between 7 and 9 p.m. So, or I guess 6 and 9 p.m. So nighttime is ideal to post in general. So you have your daughter, you have a post from somebody else, blonde. Throwback Thursday. So I'm seeing, oh, I love the pomegranates. I'm seeing a lot of family. I love this. Like here, it's not only a sweaty selfie, but you have a motivational thing saying, just get it done, basically. I would try and do more of those. And it doesn't have to be a selfie. Like, it can be a photo of your sneakers or like your water bottle or something. Just like a photo of you and what you're doing at that time is always eye-catching.
Okay.
I like your family ones. Again, I would try and add more variety with your workouts and your healthy meals, like your pomegranates, things like that. And maybe when you do post photos of your kids, maybe try and have like a motivational quote with it, or not even motivational, but talk about why you're doing Beachbody so that you can have more freedom to be with your kids, or so that you aren't, can make enough money to pay for their dance classes or something.
Okay.
You know, because I don't want to take that away from you, because I can see you like posting about them, but try and mix that with something inspiring about Beachbody. Or there's a quote for that a lot of moms do that's like, don't make them your excuse, make them your reason. So you could do an awesome photo with that.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I love seeing that. It doesn't really apply to me, but yeah. And I'm seeing that some days you post a lot, and then sometimes it goes, like maybe you miss a day or two, or just like one a day. I would try and stick to at least 3 a day and do them at various times. Like Jillian, who's not on the call right now, my sister, she joined and I was looking at her posts and she did 4 in an hour and they were great. There was like a fitness one, a health, a picture of her dinner, something about a challenge group. So they were awesome, but it was all within an hour. And not only is it a lot at once, but again, there's logic in Facebook where when you post something, your last post shows up less often. So basically when you're doing that, you're saying, hey, look at this one now, don't look at this one. So that's why it's good to space it out throughout the day rather than having it like all at once.
Okay.
So, or once a day. If you're doing once a day, you don't really know who you're going to catch. So having like morning, afternoon, evening is good. Okay. Do you have any questions?
No.
Okay. Good job. Go to Gretchen. Okay, so again, nice. So you have photos of yourself and what you prioritize, Gmail and Instagram. One thing I just thought of that you can choose to do or not is over here where you guys have like went to Batavia High School, lives here, from here, there's an option where you can add your profession. So you could add, I wouldn't do Beachbody coach. I would personally say health and wellness coach or fitness coach or something like that. And you can say at Beachbody, or I don't, mine is like at my fitness page, which I don't know if you guys have. I don't think you do. But you can add that so that when new people again come to your page, they'll see right away that you can help them with their fitness goals.
Cool.
All right, groceries. Yeah, this is an awesome post. Lauren, you don't have any checks yet from Beachbody, but anytime you get anything from Beachbody, it's always good to share the importance of it to you. So it doesn't even have to be a big check. Like Gretchen got $40, or it wasn't a $40 check, but her grocery bill went over $40 and Beachbody covered it. Okay. I mean, a lot of people post like they were able to fill their gas tank thanks to Beachbody. Like they didn't have to just put $10 and they could fill it thanks to Beachbody, right. You know.
Right. Okay.
So, and that's especially important, which kind of gets into a separate topic, but it's especially important if your target market is looking for things like that. So, for example, one of the reasons I joined was for the money, and I'm very factual and statistical. Like, I like seeing money and proof that it works and all of that. So, for me, who I'm trying to attract to my company or to my coaching opportunity and to challenge groups are people that are the same way. So people that want to see my income from month 1 to month 7.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. And like for you, if there's a lot of coaches who aren't money focused, who are like numbers focused, they're actually focused on like changing lives, and that truly is what drives them. So you could just do a post on like the very first person you talk to, and even if they didn't sign up with you, how you felt talking to them, because who you're trying to attract will want to feel that same way, you know?
Okay. Yeah.
So in essence, good post, Gretchen. so far you survived 100% of your days. You're doing great. That's good. Again, with posts like these, I always challenge you guys to use the same quote because it's an awesome quote, but try and put you or something, like one of your photos behind it.
I like that. That's a good one.
That's funny. It's eye-catching, for sure.
Yeah, I like that.
Only one person liked it?
Yeah, I posted it last night, too. Oh, actually, no, I think more than that liked it. Well, I posted it last night and it only got 3 likes, so I reposted it again tonight. And hoping to get more likes at a different time, but...
Sorry, I just refreshed. I don't know why it's happening, but this is your most recent one. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. I like that. It only has 2 likes.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking, like, maybe one thing that would make it better is add something somewhere on the photo. This is a recruiting post, a mentor. So maybe just, like, one of the starbursts that says, I want to mentor you, or looking for 5 people to mentor, like something where, because a lot of people just look at images and keep scrolling. So next time it might help to put a little blurb on what it is that you're looking for.
Okay.
But I like that. I like the eyeballs.
Thanks.
Okay, here's me. Meals, motivation. Yes, I'm seeing a lot of meals, cookies. So I would personally, I like that you're doing progress here. I might do more fitness posts, like this one. Like I had to scroll down kind of far to get to it. That was December 14th. Because I see like a lot of meals, which is awesome, but you want a little bit more variety.
Okay.
Meals and motivation is your focus right now, I'd say. So just, yeah, add a little more variety, fitness or like more of these Thank You Beachbody, especially if you're in recruiting mode. Think of other ways that you can promote how much Beachbody means to you or what life would be like without Beachbody.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Good job. All right. Any other questions from you guys before I look at the other people?
I just have a question. So if you do Instagram and Facebook, do you basically post the same thing you do on Facebook to Instagram, or do you do a different post?
So I know Grant and Lauren are both on Instagram. For me, I do pretty much the same thing just to make it easier. If I have time, I do try and make it different because I find that what I post on Facebook that does really well doesn't do so well on Instagram and vice versa.
Okay.
So, but I mean, just out of convenience and efficiency, I usually do the same thing.
Okay.
One tip though would be don't share it. You know how you can share Instagram posts to, I wouldn't suggest doing that. Yeah. You can do it maybe a couple times a month just so that people see you posted from Instagram and will go to your Instagram page.
Right.
But again, I think that there's logic behind Facebook that says if you share it, it doesn't pop up as much, especially because Instagram is a competitor of Facebook. So it's silly. It's something so silly to think about. But I think you do get more views and more engagement if you post directly to Facebook. So just copy it and then repost it.
Okay.
Yeah. Gretchen, do you post the same things to both?
No, I post much less on Instagram, but I do a lot of recruiting on Instagram. By just like recruiting them to my free group. And I've had a lot of success with that, but I do need to do a better job at posting equally on both. I probably post on Instagram maybe only like twice a week just because I'm focusing on Facebook now. It overwhelms me to do too much at once.
Yeah. Baby steps.
Yeah.
Hi, Jackie. I just saw that you were on. Did you want me to look at your page, Jackie?
Sure, that would be great.
Okay, I'll do that before these other girls.
Thanks.
All right. I love this picture of you. Ever since you posted it, I feel like I've used it for a couple of our things together. but this is good. I would also try and add either another photo or just like your contact information. Or your fitness coach, add something else here just so that when people see it, they know that you are a coach.
Okay.
It could even just be like Coach Jackie down here, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is what I was talking about. You have independent fitness coach. That's perfect at Beachbody and your special ed teacher. So that's good. All right. So first off, this is from 12 hours ago. So I would try and post again.
Okay, that's what I'm bad at.
Yeah. And it's shared from Instagram. So again, try and, it can be the same exact thing, but try and just repost it.
Okay.
And another thing I found when doing that is, at least for me on Facebook, my hashtags don't do as well. So I try and just do like maybe two funny, unique hashtags. Like rock out with your crock out. That's a good, like funny things that people will be like, that's funny, or like just be drawn to. Whereas on Instagram, if you put it in the comments specifically, but anywhere on Instagram, you can do up to 30 hashtags, which again is a different training, but that's where like hashtags is how you get followers and likes, whereas Facebook is less about hashtags and more about the content.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. That looks good. Nice, a crock pot meal. So again, for you, at least my like first scroll, I see a lot of food. I see 3-day refresh results are always great. That's a good one. Yeah, so I would say for you, do a little bit more consistent, posting at least 3 times a day.
Okay.
And also try and sprinkle in some variety. So I see like right now you're doing that crockpot group, so it makes sense.
Yeah.
But also try and add in, like, if you're working out every day, that's an easy way to just like take a picture at some point during your workout or a video and share that at some point throughout the day. It doesn't have to be right away. If you're not working out that day, then you either just don't do a fitness post or use a photo that you took from like yesterday or a couple days ago that you never used.
Okay.
And I like this. So I know this is from earlier this week, but join my crockpot group. Simply like this post or comment below and I'll add you in. So a note to everyone is you want to have these call to action. So a call to action is something where you're telling your followers what to do so that there's like no guesswork in that, in what you want them to do. Like you want them to join your group. So to join your group, what do they have to do? For here, she's saying like the post or comment below. And for anyone who likes it or commented, did you reach out to them?
Not yet. I added them in and then I figured I'll reach out. I was planning to do my reach outs like tomorrow once the group's kind of finished to see how everyone's liking it.
Okay, cool. So like Lauren, I think that you had one of these too. I don't remember which one it was. Like this one, I feel like would be perfect to have a call to action. Even though you're a newer coach, I feel like you at the very end, you could say like, message me if you're curious about gaining more freedom in your life.
Okay, yeah, you know? Yeah.
But it can be anything, like message me, comment below, like this post, share this on your timeline or tag a friend, things like that. And then the key though, is that you have to follow up with them. So like if somebody likes it, it's such an easy follow up because all you say is, oh, hey Lauren, I saw that you liked my post about freedom and having a flexible lifestyle. Is there any way I can help you? Or I saw you wanted to join my crockpot group. I can't wait for it to start. What are your favorite meals? Like just start that conversation, you know?
Okay.
Cool. So good job, Jackie. I like yours. So consistency and a bit more variety. Okay. I'm glad you made it on, Jackie.
Thanks.
Yeah. So your mom, let's see.
Yeah.
New tab. Okay. So right away, I see December 14th was her last post. So again, for Colleen, I would say consistency. When was the 14th? Is that Monday?
Monday. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So even like I say 3 times a day, at least once, like once at night would be better than once every 3 days, but try and do 3 posts a day. Like, so here is she's doing the 30-day squat challenge. If she's actually doing it, it would be great for her to like do a video of the number of squats on whatever day it is. So like yesterday, she could do a video of the 30 squats or just a photo of her doing the squats, like an update on how it's going. Also with that, she could do a call to action. So like I'm on day 3, which is 30 squats. Does anyone want to jump in on the challenge with me? Comment below. Something like that. Things that you share don't get as much visibility either. Not only that, but they're more likely to go to Liam the Leprechaun's page rather than pay attention to what you're posting. So anytime you like something from another page or even from another coach, we're all about sharing and copying and pasting. So instead of sharing it, save it as your own photo and then repost it. And if she wants to like say that she got it from Liam the Leprechaun, she can actually do like, thanks Liam the Leprechaun for posting this, you know? I mean, especially if it's from a coach, we don't care if you copy our stuff. So just save it as your own and repost it.
Okay. Yeah, she does a lot of sharing randomly.
Okay, yeah. So there's one tip. Don't share. Make it your own. Oh, so she's far in the squat challenge. So that would have been perfect for her to do another call to action up top. Good. Yeah, I would do a bit more variety as well with your healthy meals, your lifestyle, especially what you love about coaching. Sharing what you do as a coach, so many people don't know what we do as coaches. And so even just sharing that, like how maybe I woke up this morning and I was so tired and didn't want to work out, but my fitness accountability group held me accountable. I'm loving that I'm a part of a online fitness group or a Beachbody fitness group, something like that. Sprinkling those in throughout the place, not every post because people are going to not like you if you keep saying Beachbody everywhere, but every now and then it's always good. And again, with the cover photo, I would try and make it a little more known that you're a fitness coach, and like sprinkle in everything else that you're interested in as well.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Okay. Jackie was another one. So for Jackie, okay, two things. One is when you're listening to this on the replay, when I look at this, I can't see the full quote or your full body or any of that. So in the beginning of this call, I showed you how to do a PicMonkey Facebook cover. I would do that so that I can see everything. And then a second comment is that anytime you want to post something from your photos or maybe it's something from Instagram, all you have to do is click edit on your phone and then crop it out so that it's just the photo, so that it's not like anything else. And that goes not even for cover photos, just in general. I think did somebody else have that? Maybe not. Okay. So again, Jackie, you can add that you are a fitness coach. Oh, you do. You work right at Beachbody. Okay, perfect. Before and afters are always great. So that's good. Meal prep, a hobby, fitness, challenge group invite, challenge group invite. Yeah, so far, your fashion. I think today is your perfect day. So you have a transformation, meal, hobby, and fitness. Yes, from yesterday, and yesterday's this one is a good too. But from there on out, it's kind of random. And I would just try and be more consistent with what your day today was like. I think that would be really good. Bless you. And one way that you guys can kind of plan your posts, let me find it, so that you know that you're getting a challenge group invite, you know that you're getting a fitness post in, a healthy meal recipe in, a motivational post. I use what I call my social media planner, which I don't know if you can see very well, but it has Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, all the days here, the posts, and I have 4 to 5 lines for each day. I have it scheduled. So if I'm using like Hootsuite to schedule my post beforehand, I'll just check it off to see if it's scheduled, the time that I'm going to post it, and most importantly, the intention. So I actually don't have this filled out that well, but for Monday, my morning post was about hammer and chisel, and that was a challenge group recruiting. Monday morning, I was introducing a new coach. Monday afternoon was a motivational quote. And that was it for Monday. I'd posted something else on Monday night, but it's really nice to see at least your posts that you're planning and the intention. And you'll see right away, like, oh my gosh, I haven't posted at all about the coaching opportunity in 3 days or in a week. Or I have not inspired anyone with a motivating post in this many days, or I have never posted a healthy recipe, so maybe I'll try that. So that would be helpful, especially for those of you that find yourself posting the same things often. Get a social media planner, and I just made mine. I can send it to you if you want, and it'll help you plan it out ahead of time. Yeah, so that's it, I think, for Jackie. Yeah, for some of the posts, I see that she does really well. Like this transformation, she got a lot of likes, so she'll want to do that again. For this one, she got 6 likes, which isn't bad. So that's another thing all of you guys can do with your posts is go to your pages and see what people are responding to. Okay. So Karen told me why she has this photo. I even think that's a fine photo because it shows what she does. Again, just adding fitness coach or wellness coach or let me help you, something like that. And if you guys want ideas for those posts, go to the top coaches pages and they have awesome examples. So like Raina Odell is a top coach, Anita Myron, Janelle Summers, all of those people have great examples. Hold on, I'm going to refresh this because I know she has a recent post. Okay. This is a good one. So these are the types of posts that I love, is a selfie, and she is hinting at what she's doing. So this is a super awesome hairstyle brought to you by Autumn. So that people could be like, oh, who's Autumn? And then she can start talking about her trainer who's through 21 Day Fix. So kind of like hinting at it. You don't have to always say, super awesome hairstyle by 21 Day Fix, or I love 21 Day Fix and this move. Like you don't have to constantly be throwing it in people's faces, but little hints like this are really great. So she's recognizing a coach, which is great. Love this post again. Try and like toss your hair in a bun, drink a Starbucks, put some Britney on and handle it. I know Karen is a nurse and I feel like she's often in a bun and like carrying and drinking coffee. So she could actually use one of her own photos and use that quote. Somebody else posted. This is great. So this is good because she's showing she has other hobbies too. Like she likes to run. We're all about healthy lifestyle. So we don't have to constantly be posting about Beachbody as long as you're healthy. So here's, I think she got this idea from me, but so she's laying on the ground with a motivational quote behind it. Sometimes workouts are not about sore muscles, it's therapy. So things like that. Healthy recipes. I think she's doing great. December 10th. So I see she went from December 10th to 13th without posting, or I guess the 11th to 12th were no posts. So that's something I would do better at the 14th. So maybe that was just an off day, but consistency, 3 to 5 times a day. I think there was someone else, Colleen, Jackie. Yeah. All right, Kat. So again, cover photo, try and make it a little more personal with lots of different types of things in there. You can add Beachbody Coach as a job. Let's see. Okay, this is awesome. So one of your coaches is reaching out to you on your page. healthy meal. I feel like these are not refreshed. Yeah, okay. Motivation. Nice, day three. It's always good to have like day three or day four because it's kind of like people watch your journey and they feel like they're a part of it. So I like that you have day three there. Someone's watching General Hospital.
Yeah.
Hold on.
What are days of our lives?
Oh, that could be it as well. Okay. another motivational post. That's good. Yeah, Kat, I think that yours is like really good, actually. So she has a mixture of challenge groups. She's doing a giveaway. She has hobbies in there. Some motivational, which again, I'll try and make more personal. She's using this call to action, comment below or message me. So I think that's good. When your posts are good, I think the best thing that you can do is expand your network so that you get more people seeing your posts. Yeah, good job, Kat. I think that's good. Melissa Sullivan. Okay, so again, Melissa, try and make this so that I can see everything. I like that. Like, that would be a great post, but it needs to be an actual cover photo for it to appear correctly. Coach at Beachbody, nice. So your post, hold on, I'm just going to refresh. Okay. So far, so like today's posts, I would say at least try and add something in there about what you're doing, something engaging, like a question, because you're not getting too much engagement on these. This one is a good one. Yeah, I would just like, if you're going to post stuff like this, ask a question like, have you ever seen this movie, or have you ever been here, or do you do personal development, things like that. But also try and make it more personal. So like add a photo of you reading a book, or this is not related, which is fine. just something related to you, your health, your fitness, something in there at least once a day. Okay, so yesterday, love this, Mind Over Matter. So it's inspiration and you're doing something with Sean T. That's not your post. Okay, Kat, videos, always good. No day. So for Melissa, I love this one. I think this is the girl that you nanny, which you post a lot about animals and your workouts. I would say add more variety. So add, I mean, I'm saying healthy meals just because that's what I do. But if you're really into nutrition and like dissecting Pepsi or, you know, like anything that is with nutrition or anything health and fitness related, do a little bit more on like the nutrition and health side, because you do have a lot of workout posts which are good. And don't forget to do call to actions. So like this one would be perfect. You did it at night around 7. Why take it on a Monday? Because I can see progress from month 1. Who else wants to start seeing changes in their body? Comment below. You know, so add more call to actions. And again, like to get more people to like your stuff, just add more friends and connect with new people. And anytime you can have a personal transformation like Jackie's just was, instead of using stock photos like this, obviously this is for hammer and chisel, but personal photos are always better because people see that it's you and not just like some person that they have no idea who it is, who could be fake, who could be on an infomercial. Personal is always better. All right, I think I got everyone. Melissa, Kat, Karen, Jackie, Colleen. Okay, cool. So I think we're good. Do you guys have any questions or Did everything make sense that I talked about? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Okay. Cool. Well, so what I refer to, the social media planner, it's actually on the Team Supercharged training site. If you go there or just let me know and I can send that to you, that's great for everyone. It's helped. I've been in business for 2 years, and when I started doing this, I was like, it was eye-opening on how little I post about certain things and how way too often I post about others. So just kind of tracking that. And for those of you that are busy, like I know all of you have full-time jobs, the way to stay consistent is by scheduling. So if you don't have to, especially as a teacher, Jackie, if you just don't have time, and I know some schools like don't allow you to get on Facebook during the day.
Yeah.
Just try, does your school do that?
Yeah, we're blocked.
You are.
Bonus, yeah.
Yeah, so like I would try to schedule them ahead of time using the Hootsuite app or EveryPost. There's a lot of them out there. So if you just Google like Facebook scheduling, you'll find a lot. But those are the two that I use. Since you're a teacher, I feel like a lot of you're probably trying to attract other teachers, which also may be blocked during the day. So it's not a huge deal that you're not posting during the day, but at least like in the morning and at like 7 a.m., 5 p.m. and 9 p.m., those are ideal times. So scheduling will also help a lot.
Okay.
And I think that's it. Definitely start doing call to actions, variety, and consistency. I think those are the keys that I found from everyone's pages. Gretchen, are you baking cookies?
Yeah.
I saw you doing something. All right. Thanks, guys, for joining. If you have any other questions or want me to review your page in like a couple days or a week just to see if you have made some improvements, just let me know. Otherwise, I think you did great. And have a great night.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks, guys. Bye.
Bye.